According to the ancient Greeks, it all started when the Prometheus stole fire from the halls of the Olympus and brought it back to the humankind at the expense of the wrath of Zeus on himself and paying the price terribly. With the control of fire, humans became the master artisans of the Metallon and the Keramos. As the years go by, Metallon and Keramos brought such military and agricultural power and prosperity to societies that mastered the arts. As a result, the modern historians have decided to call those eras after the materials that shaped the societies and the history of those periods. After the centuries-long unsuccessful trials of the alchemists for producing gold from other metals, with the dawn of modern science, the cards were read out. As the modern science started developing the scientific method and unraveling the natural phenomena as a result, different scientific branches have developed, one of them being material science. In the modern era, although the metals and the ceramics were still maintaining their importance, a new class of materials called polymers were introduced to the family. Polymers have led to the otherwise impossible changes in the lives of the humans in modern societies. Immense amounts of the developments in the energy, electronics, aerospace, biomedical and manufacturing technologies and so on during the 20th century have put a significant importance and momentum on the material science. Our goal here in the Material Science for Non-Material Scientists series in the TMG TV is to unravel the amazing world of the material science before your eyes, and hopefully to spark a tinder of curiosity in your intellect to honor the sacrifice of Prometheus. In the first video of this series, we will start talking about the structural properties of materials, and we will cover the differences between the crystalline and the amorphous materials, symmetry operations, crystal systems and brevity lattices. We hope you enjoy the ride.